We all know that time behaves as a river. It is something that flows uninterrupted, always in the same direction, from the past to the future. It looks like that time has an arrow that points always forward. But why is it like that? What's the origin of this preferential direction? Watch this video and I will tell you. The past and the future look very different from each other. In fact, we can remember the past, but we cannot do the same with the future. We cannot go back into the past, but we can't avoid getting older. We stay still in space, but we can't do the same with time. Time cannot be stopped. The difference between past and future is clear when we watch this video. We immediately realize that we are watching something going in the wrong direction. Somebody reversed the direction of time. There is no doubt about that. Similarly, we also know that we will never see something like that happening in nature. However, when we talk about physics, we don't see this distinction between past and future. The fundamental equations of physics do not have a preferential direction in time. There is no arrow. Time is just a variable used to label different instants. But there is no preferential order among those instants. Let's imagine a very simple system consisting of two marbles. If we watch a video of the collision between these two marbles, we will have no way to tell if the video is going forward or backward in time. We can't tell which is the past and which is the future. The collision is described by equations that allow us to determine the trajectories of the marbles at any instant. But these equations are valid to calculate positions and velocities both in the past and in the future. So if we want to determine the trajectories of the marbles, we can do it both forward and backward. The equations are still the same. Time is totally symmetrical here. But then, why past and future look so different in our daily life? Why we remember the past, but we can't do the same with the future? Why it looks like time has a precise direction? If we think carefully, something similar also happens to space. For instance, there is no difference between up and down. All spatial directions are the same. The only reason we distinguish between up and down is because of gravity that attracts objects downward. The symmetry is broken by the position of the Earth that produces a preferential direction. If we were floating in the interstellar space, there would be no preferential direction because there is no gravity. Similarly, we need to understand why the basic laws of physics lose their time symmetry, leading to a distinction between past and future. To understand that, let's think about a system which is a bit more complicated, consisting of several marbles. Then, let's watch the video showing one marble hitting the others, which are initially at rest. There's nothing strange in this video. However, if we watch this video at reverse, we feel something is wrong. In this case, we can immediately tell that the direction of time has been reversed, like in the video of the broken glass. But how are we so sure about that? In reality, there is nothing impossible happening in the second video. It is perfectly possible to write equations that describe the trajectories of the different marbles, and there is nothing wrong with it. The only weird thing would be the initial conditions that are required to obtain this particular situation. The initial velocities and positions of all marbles should be set with extreme precision in such a way that they all arrive at the exact same spot at the same time. They all stop and the other marble starts moving. The reason the second video feels wrong is because that situation is very unlikely to occur spontaneously. It can only be achieved by choosing some very precise initial conditions. So, can you now guess what is the real reason the past looks so different from the future? Not yet? Let's use another example. Here, we have two pictures of the same egg. In the left one, the egg is broken. In the right one, the egg is still intact. If I ask you to put them into chronological order, you would immediately say that the picture with the egg still intact is in the past, while the one where the egg is broken is in the future. And the same is valid for the example of the broken glass. Why, we have no doubts about the chronological order of these pictures. Because in nature, we never see a broken egg spontaneously recomposing itself, or a broken glass getting back spontaneously into its original shape. These are all examples of events occurring in one direction only. In physics, we say that such phenomena are irreversible. These are phenomena in which we cannot reverse things. However, at a microscopic level, both the egg and the glass are made by particles in random motion, continuously colliding with each other, and each collision is identical to the example of the two marbles. There is no preferential direction in time. So where is the trick? The trick is that the egg and the glass, or any other macroscopic object in our daily life, are made by a huge number of molecules, and there are many more ways in which they can be arranged to result in a broken egg, rather than in an unbroken egg. In the example before, the marbles must be perfectly synchronized to hit the marble at rest all at the same time, putting it in motion so that they all stop at the same time. Here, it's the same. There should be some extremely special conditions so that all the molecules in a broken egg would go in a precise direction and with a precise velocity in order to recompose the egg. For this reason, observing a broken egg spontaneously recomposing itself is extremely much less likely than observing a whole egg breaking apart. In fact, the former never happens. In addition, heat is also produced in all these phenomena. We also know that due to the law of conservation of energy, energy can only be transformed from one form into another, but it can never be created or destroyed. However, heat is a special form of energy that once it is used, it is impossible to be retrieved completely. It's still there because energy is conserved, but somehow it becomes unusable. In physics, the amount of usable energy in a system is linked to the property called entropy. For instance, when we burn a piece of coal, the entropy of the coal and of the surroundings increases. Entropy is also a measure of the number of ways in which the particles of a system can be arranged without changing its macroscopic properties. In other words, without changing its physical appearance. In our previous example, a whole egg has lower entropy than a broken one, because there are countless ways in which the molecules can be arranged to obtain the broken egg. While a whole egg requires some precise, special arrangements for the molecules, the maximum entropy of the egg is obtained when all the molecules are completely mixed randomly and there is no trace of the original egg. In nature, we observe that entropy always tends to increase. This is also remarked in a very important law, the second law of thermodynamics. It should be clear why. In fact, it is much more likely that entropy increases rather than decreasing, because in every system, there are many more ways in which entropy can increase rather than decreasing. And in reality, much more likely here means immensely more likely. We will never see a system where entropy decreases spontaneously. And the idea of time direction arises exactly from this concept. The arrow that goes from the past to the future is the one that goes into the direction of increasing entropy. All irreversible processes that occur spontaneously in nature always go in the same direction, increasing entropy. This is why we perceive a clear distinction between past and future. We are able to put events into chronological order without any doubts, because we always link the events in the future to higher entropy, while the events in the past are those associated to lower entropy. This also explains why the past looks more real than the future. our brain elaborates external stimuli, trying to interpret what it has already happened and what it will happen next. But since entropy always increases, the reconstruction of the past is more reliable than the prediction of the future, because the number of previous conditions that can lead to the current situation is much less than the number of possible future possibilities. Without even realizing it, our way of thinking relies on the fact that entropy increases. Even when we create a memory, such as a sign on a piece of paper or a picture formed on a film, this process always implies an increase in entropy. It is not reversible. It can only happen in one direction, not the other way around. So to summarize, we perceive the passing of time because the past has a lower entropy than the future. And this is something due to the behavior of the whole universe. Our universe started from a situation of lower entropy than what it is now, and the current entropy is also lower than the future one. If the universe was in a situation of maximum entropy at the beginning, with all particles moving randomly, with all parts at the same temperature, like a gas in equilibrium, nothing relevant would have happened, no formation of stars, galaxies, and therefore, we would not have any way to define what is past and what is future. Instead, the universe evolved, moving from a situation of extreme uniformity to the current conditions in which we have planets, stars, galaxies, and in which we can even observe some extremely complex processes, such as the birth of life. So the existence of a preferential direction in time is due to the fact that entropy was lower in the past, and it keeps increasing. But till when? We don't know that. But what we know for sure is that until this happens, past and future will continue to appear much more different from each other. This ends the video here. Thanks for watching, everyone. Did you find this video about time interesting? Is there something more you want to know about the link between entropy and time? Let me know in the comments below.